Hi, this is Mike Hendrickson from Velocity in New York. I'm here with Craig from Akamai. Craig, how you doing?
Fantastic, fantastic.
So Akamai, we've worked with you guys for a long time.
Yeah.
What are you guys up to today?
There's a lot of exciting things. So the company is really focused on four grand challenges we see. You know, the first is the internet isn't designed to scale for the amount of consumption of video coming over the top. So how do we enable their customers focus on video business models to scale to meet their business models? The second is around performance. With the world is going mobile, defined as either the connection or the device, that represents almost a throwback in what organizations have to focus for both the speed and engagement of their experiences they're designing online. Third is around security, which is it is one of the hottest topics. And how do I not only have a high performing presence, but one that is able to withstand the expected attacks from bots and otherwise? And then finally, nothing to do with the website, but one of the things that our innovation has led us to is how do we help organizations lock down their enterprise security? So you look at some of the biggest security breaches that have been in the organization, inherently involves around individuals accessing parts of an enterprise's IT infrastructure that perhaps they shouldn't have been.
Are the first two related? I mean, video consumption and mobile. Are most of the video consumption on mobile?
So I think they are. First, this glue between all of them is run off of the global platform. So with every organization, you're trying to do security at the edge, streaming at the edge, mobile optimization at the edge. The point that you bring, though, is if we look at what consumers are doing with mobile devices, we're finding that everything is now happening on a mobile device greater than before. So if you think of mobile-first economies, many of us may think of less developed regions of the world. In the UK, there are more connections via mobile device to a website than there are from a PC. It's shifted that every economy is now a mobile-first economy.
So is that then making the importance of CDNs even greater now?
It is, but it's got to go beyond just CDN.
I mean,
to be transparent, dumb caching can only give you so much benefit when you're looking to optimize for mobile. You have to be able to go a step further and look at things like image adaptation, security, native mobile app performance by having software on the device. It really is the Wild West of reinvigorating the software on the platform and not just the platform itself.
So when does that Wild West slow down?
I don't think it ever does. Mm-hmm. I think the reason behind it is the expectations of consumers continually rise, which is you look at a modern website or mobile app 10 years ago and compare it to now, it's a dramatically different environment. And so what we see is constantly consumers demanding more instantly, involving third parties securely, and that's a big challenge for particularly global organizations to face.
So you gave an insightful keynote this morning. What would you like developers to take away from what you were talking about today?
Yeah, so before, I think there used to be an either or that developers faced, which is if I want to adopt DevOps and have a full developer and operations control, that means every piece of my infrastructure has to be inside of my direct control and, frankly, mine. What we have been working on is how do you enable developers to have the innovation speed that they require, but also the power of an edge platform combined and controlled in the way that they want. So I would say that the task of I can either choose a CDN or I can choose to be DevOps friendly, that's the number one takeaway that people are correctly migrating to.
And is that where DevOps people need to go, or are they naturally migrating this way, or
is it forcing them to go that way? I think step one. So step one, and this is really the dev more than the ops, is how do I continue to innovate at the speed I need? The second piece is the ops side of DevOps is the area ripe for innovation. So most organizations, if you look at what are the things you're going to optimize or focus on fixing, it's emotional. It's not as scientific or as programmatic as we would like to see. And so we're also focused on significant innovation on the ops side of how do I give the visibility and insight, which then allows organizations to prioritize things that have a business impact. Because at the end of the day, as developers, technology is great, but it's got to solve a business purpose. And we can turn our development teams into heroes by allowing them to articulate the impact of their project in business terms. And that's exciting.
It almost sounds like a little bit of UX in there, too. Like DevUX?
Yeah, well, I think there's part of it. I think you're right. The motion that it's going is the richer experience that you're able to give. I also think a big part of the organization is the prioritization side, which is I just can't. Every development organization is people constrained. And so how do you know what to focus on first? And that's what we focused our ops side of it on, is that visibility insight.
So where do you see Akamai going with what you guys have today and how you're going to address DevOps 12 months from now?
It's fascinating. So I think first, I believe where we're at with DevOps is we're there today. We're going to continue to innovate and expand and delight our customers in even further ways. I think what you'll see us also innovating more aggressively around is IoT. And if you look at IoT, there's a lot of focus on delivering to the device and securing the device. And we do that, and we've done that for quite a while. The next big challenge is going to be receiving data from the device. And how then do I take and process that in a low latency, sensitive, scalable, global way? That's a great opportunity for Akamai to continue to innovate.
So if you had one thing that a CIO could do to increase and improve their performance of their whole platform that they have, what is the most important thing to start with?
Yeah, I start with insight. And so when I talk to executive teams, they're data rich and information poor, which is they have numerous data sources. Mm-hmm. And then when I ask them of which one guides you of where you should focus on your organization, that's when you tend to have the longer pauses. The first thing I would do to that organization is start having them articulate the technical impact, the business impact of technology, and specifically address through what we refer to as MPulse. That helps help organizations prioritize where they should focus that has an ROI, and then perhaps where that may be not ideal performing, but there's no business impact, they should save their resources elsewhere. That insight then becomes the pivot point of where you then start working on what has a business impact at the end.
Excellent. Craig, we look forward to working with you in the future.
Excited to be here. Thanks so much.